Will facial threading droop your skin? That's the question I'm being asked by Darlene. Let's listen.
Yes, hi. I want to know if facial threading, the end result, does it pull the skin tight to where whenever it's not working anymore, the skin is looser after the product is gone? I just don't want to have anything done that's going to cause the skin to become looser because I had it done.
Great question, Darlene. So facial threading, I think she's referring to, of course, PDO threads. There's other materials, PLLA and PCL, but PDO threading is how most people know it, polydioxinone. And there are smooth threads that build collagen, and there are threads that have little barbs on them that lift. And she's really referring to those lifting threads. And when they go away, will the face be saggier? Likely because people think it's under tension. If there's too much loose skin, people are not a candidate for this because where's that skin going to go? But what PDO does, and many people have had PDO in their body because they're found in resorbable sutures. So if you've ever been sewn up for anything and the sutures dissolved, often that's PDO. Around that area, you'll notice the skin's often better or tighter. And that's because there's collagen, fibroblasts, wound healing in that area that tightens your skin, uses your natural body's mechanism of tightening. So the answer of the smooth threads, they don't lift, but they tighten and they build collagen. And most people do them a couple times a year, depending on what you're trying to do. Good areas are smile lines, lip borders. The neck is a great area, the tummy. The barbed threads where we're lifting, most people want to lift the edge of the mouth and the cheek and lift the face back and underneath the jawline. Those are three common vectors. Your skin will not, I've never done hundreds, thousands of these, hundreds and thousands, not hundreds of thousands, but definitely in the thousands, and of course teach around the world on these. I've never heard of or personally seen a case where the skin got looser after, and the reason is, what we're doing, yes, there's the lift that everyone likes, but it's a larger thread, so we're taking an 18 gauge cannula and the thread fills that like a 00 suture. That amount of product in the face stimulates collagen, and this is where the FUD, the fear, uncertainty, and doubt by some practitioners of it building scar tissue. I'm not going to go into all what scar tissue is today, just suffice it to say that those are people that haven't done thread lifts, or they're seeing people in their clinic that other people have done thread lifts on that weren't appropriate candidates. But for people with minimal to moderate loose skin who want a little lift, who want a tightening, threads, in my opinion, work great. And yes, you can have a facelift after them, very common. I have a whole interview with plastic surgeons who do facelifts after threads. But there's a group of people that want to make people fearful because these are newer procedures that they don't understand. They don't know about, or maybe it threatens their livelihood, who knows. So get real information from real people doing this every day with no motive. But I've never seen anyone with more loose skin after. In fact, it does the opposite. But with threads, you have to be the right candidate or you will be disappointed. You also have to see, if you're getting lifting threads especially, someone who's an expert in them and that can deal with any side effects that occur, because we are doing more major work. These are big threads. It's America. People want their face jacked up. They are expecting a lot of lift. So people sometimes put 15, 20 lifting threads in a face. Too many, in my opinion. But again, find a great practitioner, be realistic. And if you need a facelift for what the result in your head, for what you want to see, don't get threads. Get a facelift first and then get your other treatments. Great question, Darlene. Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.